Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife for you. Today we're going to take a look at a knife from a Spanish knife company called Miguel Nieto Knives. And they produce their knives since 1957 in a traditional way, all made in Spain, in Albacete. And they are determined to provide an affordable, high-quality product for the everyday people. So really cool overall company, and they also have really cool and interesting designs available on their website, and really a lot of them. They really produce a wide variety of different pocket folding knives and also fixed blades that you can choose from. And they really know how to blend a traditional knife with some more modern materials, like here on this model, which is the Climber model number 402-V. A very nice slip joint folder by Miguel Nieto Knives, which is of course made 100% in Spain with their proprietary steel, which we're going to talk about later on. But first, as always, we're going to take a look at the specs of the Climber. And here we have an overall length of 17.5 centimeters or 6.8 inches, which gives you a blade length of 7.5 centimeters or about 3 inches of the AN58 proprietary Miguel Nieto steel, and a handle length here of 10 centimeters or 3.8 inches with a very nice bolstered micarta scale look here. And now we're gonna take a look at the weight of the Nieto Climber. And the Nieto Knives Climber weighs 72 grams or 2.5 ounces. So a quite lightweight pocket knife that you have here. Really, really nice weight, especially if you're carrying this in slacks or in your suit jacket. This is not going to drag it down that much. A really nice gentleman's carry option, in my opinion. Now let's take a closer look at the 3-inch long AN58 steel blade on the Nieto Knives Climber right here. You see you have a classic drop point blade shape with a hollow grind and a little bit of a flat portion up here, and also your nail nick to deploy the slip joint blade quite easily with two hands. And you also can see all the markings on the blade here. We have the model name, the Climber up there, and you also can see the Miguel Nieto Knives logo right here, and the name Nieto, and that it is made out of AN58 steel, and the AB logo for Albacete and Spain on top of that. So a lot of logos here on the blade that let you know where it's made and which steel it is wearing right here. So the AN58 proprietary steel that Miguel Nieto Knives uses here has quite an interesting composition. You have 0.45% carbon and 13.5% chromium in it, and a lot of elements that improve the overall capabilities of the steel, like manganese, molybdenum, nickel, vanadium, and so on. The steel is actually hardened to about 58 to 60 Rockwell, so a really nice hardness that they can achieve here on this steel. And in my experience, it really performs way better than you would expect from the sheer carbon content. So it really outperforms its material composition. It has a very fine grain structure overall, so you can get a really razor sharp edge on this AN58 steel. And also it has a very, very nice corrosion resistance because of the high chromium content. What really surprised me on this AN58 steel is the very good edge holding capability that you wouldn't expect from a steel with these amounts of carbon in it. And they also seem to do a very, very nice job on the sharpening and heat treating of this blade, because it came razor sharp out of the box and also holds the edge, as I said, for quite a long time. So overall, a really nice steel choice, and a steel that I haven't known before, but I'm quite impressed with the steel that they have used here on the Nieto Climber and most of the Nieto knives that they offer. You also see you have a satin finished blade with the hollow grind right here, and not a too thick blade, but for these kind of knives I think the blade thickness is quite nice, and you can see the tip strength right here as well. So just a nice traditional style slip joint folder blade, my opinion. On the other side you also have a marking that the blade is made in Spain right here on the Ricasso. Other than that, this side of the blade is completely sterile. Now let's take a closer look at the beautiful handle construction here on the Nieto knife's Climber. And you can see here you have two pieces of micarta. Here we have a green canvas micarta for the lower part of the handle. There is also a black canvas micarta and a blue one available, and also different kinds of woods as well. And on the top, it's a little bit hard to show you, but you can see the structure in it. It is actually also micarta, white micarta scales here for the bolster of the knife. You also can see that it is a pin construction. Here you have also a quite nice black pivot color around the pivot pin right here, which also looks really nicely and is finished extremely well. You can't feel the transition because it's just inlaid quite excellently, and also the transitions between the micarta materials here is very well done. And the green micarta scale right here is finished quite smoothly, but it still offers a little bit of grip. You can feel the structure of the micarta a little bit on the handle as well right here. So really nice finish that they have chosen here on the handle scales. If you rotate the knife like this, you can see the stainless steel liners that they have as well in here. And also under the green micarta scales, you have these red liners for a pop of color, which extend all the way through and really make this knife a very, very handsome knife. I really love how they put the handle here together with the different materials and the colors that they have chosen here. So really, really well done. And you also can see the fit and finish is just exceptional. Everything is rounded very, very well. Here on the top, you can also see the finishing on the bolster part, your finger groove right here. So just really overall a very, very nice handle construction and design. Here you have the other side of the handle. Here you see the pivot pin without a collar and the other body pins as well. So really nice overall handle design. And here you see on the back, you even have some file work on the spine right here all the way up. Just really, really well done. And you also see the tolerances are very, very nice. You can't see any kind of gaps right here. Just fit and finish is outstanding on this Miguel Nieto knife. And if you close the knife up, of course it's a slip joint, so there is no lock to disengage. See a very positive detent. And that's how it looks in the closed position. Just a really, really gorgeous overall handle design. I really like it very, very much, and haven't seen anything like it from any other company. Here you can see how it looks in the hand. So really nice, very comfortable in hand. For my hand, it's the absolute perfect size. Really a smooth and comfortable handle. Because of the file work on the spine, you get a little bit of grip up here. It's nearly like a bit of jimping. I really like the finger groove in front of here. So a really, really nice, comfortable, and very, very good looking handle design. And very, very well done fit and finish on this knife here. Now let's take a look at the centering here on the Miguel Nieto knife's Climber. And you can see centering is also done quite well. Nearly perfect centering right here, and you also can see the fit and finish here on the butt end of the knife. You just cannot feel any kind of transition. It is just done extremely well. Overall fit and finish on this knife is absolutely exceptional. especially for the price that these knives come in. I wouldn't expect a fit and finish of this premium quality that you get here on your Miguel Nieto knife climber. Also, all the body pins right here are fit very nicely, flush with the scale, so you are not going to feel them in your hand. There is absolutely no hot spot here on this climber model whatsoever. Everything is rounded perfectly. Also, the deployment is very smooth and very easy. Of course, it's a slip joint knife, so there is no lock that you have to disengage. But the spring that I used here is also not too weak, so you can put a little bit of force on the spine right here, and it's not going to fold right away. But of course, it is not the safest knife to use for any kind of harder use tasks. But I think for a gentleman's carry to open letters and stuff like that, a knife like this is a very nice choice, and it's just a very ornate, the very ornate handle that really drew me to this knife, with all the little features that they have with the red liners and the file work here on the back spine. Here you can also see how the slip joint spring rises up if you close the knife, and then you have your detent, which works also very, very nicely. Just put it over the end here. You can see how it is sucked into the handle by the detent very, very securely. There is also absolutely no way that you're going to shake out this blade. It's really secure in there. And also, as I said, the deployment with the nail nick is very easy, but of course, it's a two-handed knife, that is for sure. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of the Miguel Nieto knife's climber. I now had this knife for about a month and used it in my EDC rotation. And now let's see how it cuts paper. It is the same cut test I do with all of my knives in the videos, so I think if I do it for all of the knives, you can really get a feel of the sharpness because you can compare it to all the other knives that I did the cut test with. But you can see here, it is no problem to cut the paper here with the Miguel Nieto knife's climber. So really, really sharp, and also holds the edge for quite a long time, as you have seen here. After a month of EDC rotation, it still cuts paper with ease. Now let's come to the size comparison I like to do, so you can get a feel for the size of the knife in front of you. First size comparisons I have is a flipper knife from CRKT. It is the CRKT Premonition, which is sadly discontinued, but I thought the overall design has a lot of similarities, so I thought I would show you that. But these are also quite similar in the overall size. As you can see here, the Premonition is a little bit longer overall, but you can see the similarities in the overall design, in the handle design. Also very nicely rounded and contoured handle here on the Premonition by CRKT. Another comparison I have for you would be the Oda Knives OFF FK7, which is a slip joint folder by Hiroaki Ota, a Japanese custom knife maker. And you can see these knives are also quite similar in the overall size. The climber is a slight bit longer at the blade right here. This is an extremely lightweight and a knife that it is legal in a lot of places because it's a slip joint folder and not has a very, very long blade. So really nice and extremely smooth and affordable custom knife. In my opinion, I really like my OFF FK7 a lot. And the last comparison I have for you is also a non-locking knife out of Bulgaria. Is this one the Manly Comrade in the black and blue grooved G10 handle scales? And you can see the Comrade is quite a bit larger if I put these two pivot to pivot than the Climber. Here you also have the D2 steel and the nice grooved G10 scales. But this knife is of course a heavier knife and also a bigger and more harder use knife in my opinion. And you also get a clip here on the Manly Comrade, which you are not going to get on your Climber model by Nieto Knives. So I think these three comparisons could give you an idea of the size of the Miguel Nieto Knives Climber. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about the Miguel Nieto Knives Climber model number 402-V right here. And price is one of the best parts about these knives that I've seen so far. It is an extremely competitive price and you are really getting a lot for your money. If you want to get yourself a Climber model like this one here, you're going to pay under $30, which is just unheard of for the amount of quality, fit and finish and materials used that you get here on the Climber model by Nieto Knives. Fit and finish is exceptionally well done with all the different design features that you have here. They really put a lot of thoughts in the design and the production of these knives, with all these little features like the file work, the bolstered look, and even the pivot color, which you are not going to see on a lot of other production knives. And just fit and finish, you also get a really nice overall steel with the AN58 proprietary steel that they use and developed. You get a very nice sharp edge and just an overall really, really well designed and extremely high-end looking slip joint folder. So if you want to get into a nicely built slip joint for the first time, I would highly recommend to look at the website of Nieto Knives and see if there is one that you like, and then check it out, because they have really competitive prices and put out a superb quality product in my opinion. They also have a lot of different models to choose from. There are a lot of wood handled models, there are also lockback models available, and so on. So you really can choose the thing that you like the most. But quality wise, I am really impressed by the Miguel Nieto Knives company, and especially by the Climber model that I have right here. I think it's a really nice modern twist on a traditional slip joint knife. So a highly recommended knife by me. And this was my review of the Miguel Nieto Knives Climber. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about this knife or anything else I talked about in the video, please leave it in the comments. I will try to answer you there. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.